Hello Anna, thank you for encouraging people to express their own thoughts about what is happening and for providing a platform for us. My name is also Anna, I'm 50 years old and I'm an online teacher. I've also been practicing as a therapist for nearly 20 years. I'm keen to avoid reiterating what others have already said and wanted to talk about some of the psychological reasons why people struggle to accept that they're being continually lied to about COVID, of course, but also other issues. I wanted to talk a little bit about what we can do about this on a practical level. Psychologists have known for years that there are a significant proportion of people who are psychopathic and have no qualms about exploiting others for their own purposes. There are also a very large number of people who may not be psychopathic as such, but have a weak moral compass and can be co-opted by the psychopaths for help and support. The common misconception is that psychopaths end up in jail as violent criminals, that undoubtedly most of them are likely to be sitting in boardrooms or government offices, or ordinary offices for that matter. This point is important because the classic mistake that most people make when assessing the world around them is to assume that other people are just like them. When they listen to governments and medical practitioners, alleged philanthropists and corporations promoting and justifying policies like lockdown, it doesn't occur to them that these people could be participating in an ugly attempt at mass manipulation, because they themselves would never sink so low. It is simply beyond their imaginations that there are people who are so evil that they would deliberately concoct elaborate stories and enact policies that destroy many people's lives. This reminds me of what Hitler once wrote about the relative plausibility of the big lie. Writing in his book Mein Kampf about ordinary people, Hitler states that, and I quote, "In the primitive simplicity of their minds, they more readily fall victims to the big lie than the small lie, since they themselves often tell small lies and little matters, but would be ashamed to resort to large-scale falsehoods. It would never come into their heads to fabricate colossal untruths, and they would not believe that others could have the impudence to distort the truth so infamously, even though the facts which prove this to be so may be brought clearly to their minds. They will still doubt and waver and will continue to think that there may be some other explanation. For the grossly impudent lie always leaves traces behind it, even after it has been nailed down, a fact which is known to all expert liars in this world and to all who conspire together in the art of lying." And this is in volume 1 of Mein Kampf, chapter 10. Propaganda isn't just about the content of the lie, but also the style in which lies are delivered. They are made more powerful by the sentimentality that has become so endemic in our media. Every issue, every story has to be portrayed from a human interest angle, with the minimum of analysis or detail. We are fed less and less information and more crude emotion. This is no accident, but the deliberate fostering of the primitive simplicity that Hitler referred to through an attack on our rationality and our ability to connect accurately with the many unpleasant realities in the world. It also underpins the virtue signaling that has become so ubiquitous. So for those of us who want to unmask psychopaths and minimise their power to do us harm, our principal task is to educate our friends and family about the psychological reality of evil, and I use the word advisedly, and the sentimental mask that evil often wears, and how the best way to unmask evil is to trace the numerous conflicts of interest that occur in public life. Just like good detectives do, we can follow the money. We can do this by educating ourselves about past instances in which official lies were disproved. everyone can compile and memorize a list of examples for themselves, which they can use in conversations with others, simply to point out the evident truth that the public lie is a very real phenomenon and must be considered as a possibility in all instances. Sometimes we might be just planting a seed that will come into fruition at a later point. We may never know if we've had any impact, and we have to let go of the egotistical need to know. If we can help just one person to achieve a more accurate appraisal of reality and all that that implies, we will have done a great deal. If we can repeat this with several people, we will have done a marvellous job. Anyway, thank you very much again, Anna. Yours is the real public service broadcasting.